Hey, welcome to this video. It is Sarah Michaels here. So chances are you landed here because you are wondering what the heck to do because you have that like irritating client or customer that is continually calling you, interrupting you, texting you, random hours, whatever. And you're like, what the heck do I do? Because I just want to pull my hair out. Okay, first of all, I have totally been there. So if you guys are new here, or you don't know who I am, I'm going to give you a less than 60 second background. So my name is Sarah Michaels. I've been an online entrepreneur for going on 10 years. I've been in various companies. I also own my own agency. I've done high level consulting, worked with like 6, 7, and 8 figure brands and businesses. And so some of what we do for our clients, in addition to consulting and like coaching, is we also offer done for you services for our clients and like premium packages. Okay, like, you know, branding, marketing, that sort of thing. So when I very first got started in business, I was just so excited to have a client that I would like kind of bend over backwards to do whatever they wanted. And because I just wanted to be there, I wanted to make them happy. I needed to pay my bills. I had quit my job as like marketing for tourism. So I needed that money. So I was just all about doing whatever it took. Now, when I got further on down the road, obviously I had been in business then for, you know, 2+ years. And I'm at the point then in business where I'm like, this isn't working anymore. I had clients who were just, you know, texting me on my personal phone number all the time. They were calling me, they were texting me at random times, like, hey, do this, I need this done. Like, I'm talking like midnight. They would email me, they would text me multiple times, calls, weekends. They wanted me to work on the weekends. And so I found myself, obviously, that is not sustainable. And I found myself in the place where I was like, I have a life, I've got kids, I need to go live that life. This isn't working for me. And what I realized was that I had, first of all, you have to take 100% responsibility for your life and for your business. So that is like a direct quote out of one of my very favorite books, The Success Principles, changed my life. So I took a step back and was like, okay, if I either create or allow every situation or circumstance in my life, how am I allowing this? How am I creating this circumstance? So the first thing that you have to realize is that you have created an environment where you have allowed your clients 24/7 access to you at all times. Okay, you have not set these boundaries in place. And I know it's hard to hear this, but there is light at the end of the tunnel. And I'm only saying this because I have been where you're at, and it is, you just want to pull your hair out. It's not sustainable. It's ridiculous. And you need some you time. Like, you're a professional and you deserve that. And I want to help you get there. So please hear me when I say that unless you have a client who is on a premier VIP package paying you like, I'm talking like $10,000 per month. Okay. So now if a client of mine wants to get on like my ultimate package where they have 24/7 access to me, great. You're looking at 10 grand plus. Okay. Like, I'm talking, if you want private access to my personal messenger to be able to message me whenever and get like immediate feedback. Okay, great. I'll do that for $10,000 plus. All right. So what you, sorry, there's like, we live in a beautiful lake house, but it is springtime right now. And so there's like these teeny little ants that are crawling and they're so gross. So I just smacked them. Anyways, so what you have to do is be very clear and set the boundaries, okay? This is going to be a little bit harder if you are trying to set boundaries with old clients who are just used to having you and having 24/7 access to you all the time, every day of the week, all right? So that's what I can tell you, is it's going to be a little bit different, but what you can do is you can send a friendly email out letting them know, hey, I really want to appreciate your business, your continued business, being able to serve you as a valued customer. Feel free to type this up, write it down, by the way. However, in order to best serve our customers, we are having a change to our service hours. Okay. And so from now on, here are the client support or customer service hours. And this is where you get to set your hours. You can say, I will now be answering, or if you have a team or if you want to sound more professional, you can say, we will now be handling, you know, customer service requests Monday through Thursday from 9 a.m. Central Time to 3 p.m. Central Time. And then you're only responsible for being, you know, available during those hours. And if they contact you outside of that, whatever. Okay, so this is the time when you're going to be setting those boundaries. You can also say, if you have an adjustment that needs to be done to your work or you have a project, you must fill out the project request application. Let them know what your turnaround time is, because honestly, if you have a client that's continually asking you like, hey, I need this done, you know, like next week, do you think you can squeeze that out? No. Like, even if you could, you shouldn't. Why? Because value your time. Teach that you're not helping that person by allowing them to be irresponsible. And if they want some kind of big campaign done in the next week, well, then they better be willing to pay like 3x, you know, times for like an expedited project delivery fee. Okay. So that's my thought process on that. So you have to set the clear boundaries. Let them know when you're available. Also, going forward, don't give out your number to, my husband's looking up, I think one of my kids caught a fish. Don't give out your number, your personal phone number. Don't do that. Don't give that out to clients. They don't need it. They shouldn't have it unless they are on like a VIP package. Contacting you by email is enough. If they want to get phone support, they could have phone support, but they can't access you 24/7. Okay. So they have to schedule an appointment in order to contact you, have them go through that whole thing. There should be a limited number of phone consultations with whatever service they have. If they want to go above and beyond that, then they're looking at paying for an hourly rate for a consultation. Okay, so setting those really clear boundaries. Don't give out your personal phone number. I recommend actually using Google Voice. You can also tell, so if you have an existing customer who's had access to you by phone for like years, you can say, again, with the shift in our services, we're now using a professional, you know, a different phone number. This is not my personal. This will be for business. And what you can do is you can actually create a Google Voice number, give that to them. And then, you know, if they want to leave a voicemail or something, it will ring your phone, but you don't have to answer. Isn't that awesome? And then, you know, obviously, once you get down in the future, hiring out customer service, hiring out someone to answer your phone so that you're not, you know, tied to that and tied to people who just want to contact you all the time. Because a lot of the times customers just want to talk to you, or your clients just want to talk to you, and their time sucks. They're like time vampires. Like, so instead of being productive, you're being a manager, which is what you don't want to do if you want to continue to go up in your profit. So I hope this was at least a little bit helpful. So just to recap, if you've been pulling your hair out with customers or clients who are wanting to get access to you 24/7, you need to set some clear boundaries in place. Going forward, when you're starting a project, I would let people know that they can get a hold of you via email. Don't give out your personal phone number. Get a Google Voice number and have packages available if they want that VIP or additional support. So for example, we do offer VIP packages to our customers if they want access to, you know, oh, you want phone support, or you want to, you know, have us do live tutorials with you, great, we can set that up, but that is going to be extra. This makes sure that your time is being respected, that you're not fostering like codependent business owner, like baby clients who just need you for everything just so that they can feel better, because that's not good for anybody. So thank you so much for watching. It is truly an honor and a pleasure to be able to help you get to grow your business, like level up your life and all of that jazz. So if you want to connect with me, I will go ahead and put my links down below. If you're interested in working with me, I do offer one-on-one mentoring and consulting. It is by application only and it's not cheap. But again, if that's something that you're looking at, I'll go ahead and put the link down below. And if you are interested in growing your business, but you're getting tripped up by the tech, my most popular membership option is called What the Tech. And I will go ahead and put a link down there because you can test out a 30-day trial for just $7. So again, thank you so much. If this video is helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, click subscribe, and be sure to check me out on other social media channels as well. And come say hey, like if you pop over on Instagram, be like, hey, I'm coming over from YouTube or whatever, and I try to answer every comment back on Instagram. YouTube, I don't know why it is. It's more challenging for me on YouTube. But so anyway, so there's that. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I'll see you in the next video.